5 seconds to go. Start. In his welcome speech, the Union Home Minister referred to the effective leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi in tackling the COVID-19 pandemic and said that India has achieved the milestone of 100 crore vaccinations and is moving forward with good pace. He said that the world was appreciating India's success in the battle against the pandemic, which was fought under the leadership of the Prime Minister with the motto of Ek Rashtra, Ek Jan, Ek Man. The Home Minister said that this year's conference had special importance as the nation is celebrating Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. On the Independence Day this year, the Prime Minister has made an appeal to celebrate Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav in the spirit of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Vishwas or Sabka Prayas with maximum public participation. He said that in enhancing public participation in this Mahotsav, governors and Raj Bhavans can play an important role. He said that the government will not limit the Amrit Mahotsav with the 75th year only, but also celebrate the next 25 years as Amrit Kal, make a commitment for India at 100 and work to achieve it. Amrit Kal will be a period for achieving new heights of success and prosperity for the people and the country. He expressed confidence that governors will actively participate and contribute in this endeavor. He said that the National Education Policy 2020 envisions education with Indian values. He noted that according to an estimate, about 70% universities in the country are state universities, in which around 80% of the total student population of India is getting education, and governors are chancellors of most of these universities. He said that therefore the role of governors in implementing the national education policy is very crucial. Guidance of governors is very important in appointments of teachers, admission process, and improving the level of education in these universities. He said that the government of India has decided to celebrate November 15, the birth anniversary of Bhagwan Birsa Munda, as Janjatiya Gaurav Divas every year. He said that as we are celebrating Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav this year, we will celebrate Gaurav Week instead of Gaurav Divas during November 15 to 22. From next year, November 15 will be celebrated as Janjatiya Gaurav Divas. By celebrating Janjatiya Gaurav Divas, we are honoring the contribution of the tribal community in the freedom struggle, conservation of environment and development of the nation. He appealed to governors to celebrate the Janjatiya Gaurav Divas in their respective states. In his closing remarks, President Kovind urged governors to adopt in their states the best practices discussed in the conference. He said that earlier in this forum, we had discussed cooperative federalism and competitive federalism. Cooperation and competition have a prominent place in social life. This gives a momentum to life. But this era is of collaboration. If people are benefited by a new experiment of one state, that experiment should be adopted in other states 2. The first conference of governors was held at the Rashtrapati Bhavan in 1949, which was presided over by Shri C. Rajagopalachari, Governor General of India. Since then, 51 such conferences have been organized in the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Stop.